see, we get lots of questions focusing on a specific personality. Some of them I like, some of them I dislike, or some of the sectarian movements. Some of them I like, some of them I dislike. We do not go down that line, because then we will perhaps start in the mudslinging, you know, situation. We'd rather not do that. That's why we avoid naming any personality or vilifying any personality. We just talk in general terms.
So the question was, there's this particular sectarian movement. They believe that the personality that they've chosen to be supreme, and every other personality is like a demigod, right? So what do you, what would you say around a sectarian movement that is having that kind of ethos?
Okay, suppose there are some great devotees of that particular movement. They like that particular godhead. They are enchanted by that godhead. They like to sing and praise and move towards that godhead. I say, good luck, my friend. Carry on your journey. But do not insist your particular very limited blinkered vision regarding spirituality on people of other sectarian movements or people of other religions or people of no religion. Don't you dare do that. If a particular method suits your temperament, you've got this blinkered, you're moving to your destination. We wish you well, my friend. We don't undermine you. We say, carry on. You're on a good pathway. Yes, it's a good way. Go on. Go ahead. Go to your destination. Stop telling other people to give up their pathway and follow your destination. Don't do that. This is your way, this other way. Look, I did an assembly at Eton College yesterday morning. I will hope I could record it, but they didn't let me record it. There's no way to get permission. Okay. But in the thing, I did use this particular example, which I used on the TV many times. I said, two boys playing football, best friends, kicking a ball around. While they're playing, one says, you know what? My mom is the best in the world. Boys like that. Their mom is so lovely. I say, what do you mean your mom is best? My mom is best in the world. Boys say, how dare he say his mom is, my mom is best in the world. The second boy says, my mom is the best in the world. Do you know why? She cooks the best food. Boys, mom is food. There's a link, a primitive link. And the first boy says, your mommy's food is good. You brought those homemade, well, if it's in Eton, I said cakes. But here I say, if you brought those homemade laddus, they were like rock solid. They were hard. You could break windows with those. So I said, so the boy said, your mom is cooking rubbish. Now, if you tell any boy of any age, even 35-year-old, 55-year-old boy, that their mom is cooking is rubbish, it is the beginning of World War III. And boys being boys, they like to sort things out physically. So they both roll up the sleeves. I told you, come, how dare his mom is cooking rubbish. They start thumping you, whacking you, they're, you know, thumping, you know, so they're both bleeding. They love their mommies, they're bleeding. How dare he say that? A wise man passing by, I should say a pluralist passing by, said, stop it. I'll give you a resolution to your problem, says the wise man. Say with all the love and devotion you muster that my mom is the best. But then at the end of your sentence, add two magic words. And the boys like Harry Potter and magic. Yes, what's magic word? He said, say with all the love and devotion, my mom is best.
To me.
For me. For me. Not for somebody else. And the boy was, yes, exactly. My mommy doesn't know this chap. So there you are. In 2 minutes, they become best friends, start playing football again. I wish the theologians of the world would listen to what I actually said it at Canterbury Christchurch University, at Oxford University Theology College, and they turned red in the face because they swallowed it. They like the story. It makes sense. But they can't abandon their exclusivist agenda. Their mommy is the best. And Mr. Lakhani's mommy is really secondary. He's demigod. So whenever you hear this, use this example and say that, look, this is your way, your mommy. You like her cooking? Good. Good for you. But leave me out. I don't like her cooking. Full stop.